the intense fear of needles, or trypanophobia, is the reason that 5.3 million Americans who actually want the vaccine has not gotten it as of yet, or may not get it.
Keep it 100, I be feeling like Campbell's soup over white rice, baked chicken with the skin on, yeah, Lowry's with black pepper, I'm fully seasoned with that.
What's up, y'all? So one of the main reasons that I made my channel is because I not only wanted to keep it 100, keep it real with how I feel about other people, politicians mostly, but also media figures and personalities, just how I feel about things in general. It was not just to keep it real about those issues and situations. It was also to keep it 100 about myself. So, as many of you know, or many of you don't, who knows? So, I've said it in many videos that on the 29th of this month, I'm having surgery. So if you didn't know, now you know I'm having surgery. And for the longest while, I was pretty excited about the surgery because I've had trouble walking for the past 10 years, knee, hip, ankle issues, so many things going on. So I'm supposed to be having surgery on my ankle on the 29th, and it's supposed to at least relieve the issues I've been having with my ankle. And I was excited for it for a very long time until, you know, it starts getting closer to the surgery date. And then one day I woke up with the grim realization that if I'm going to have this surgery, at some point a needle is going to be in my arm. And I have an intense fear of needles. And I didn't always have this fear of needles. So before going into when I acquired this fear of needles, I guess, I'm going to explain what this fear of needles is. I'm not the only person that experiences this, but I'll explain more of that as this video goes on. So what I have is called trypanophobia, and it affects 20 to 30% of adults. The causes of it are unknown, but it's believed that it causes changes in brain chemistry, or it could be due to changes in pain chemistry rather, and past traumatic experiences could play a role. For some, the concerns of needles can range from mild anxiety to a phobia that's so strong that it can prevent some from seeking medical care. Some symptoms include anxiety, panic attacks, dizziness, fainting, insomnia, high blood pressure, elevated heart rate, or feeling emotionally or physically aggressive. And 16% of adults, in America at least, don't get vaccinated at all because of this condition, trypanophobia. So, for me, like I said, I didn't always have an intense fear of needles, and it really began after I had my first surgery, because prior to the surgery, I was fine getting a needle. I was getting a needle. I was good. I remember one of the first times I remember having a needle, I was around 4 years old. It hurt, I cried, but now I realized, like, oh, it's not so bad, and I got the needle again. I was like, look, I could take this. Like, I'm a big boy now. So it didn't really matter after I got my first needle, and I didn't care after that for a very long time. But that all changed on February 2nd, 2012, after I had my surgery. Everything went downhill after that. And what happened was, there was one of the nurses, she was a Haitian lady. I guess overall she was nice, but she was not a good nurse whatsoever. I had surgery, and I had a needle in my arm. She had to give me an injection for something. And I'm a dude that is, you know, I have a decent amount of muscle mass, and I was even bigger back then at the time, had more muscle than I did now, because I played football back then. I don't need to be as big now, because I no longer play football. I stay fit, just stay fit. So I had higher levels of vascularity back then than I do now. So she came to administer an injection into me, and she is poking around for veins, and she kept saying, oh, this vein no good, 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 this vein no good. And she gave me about 15 to 20 pricks. I actually counted the exact number, but I can't remember it anymore because that was years ago. But it was somewhere between 15 to 20 pricks where she could not find a vein. And I was so drugged up and high on drugs that I couldn't really express how much pain I was feeling. And she just kept poking me, poking me, poking me, poking me. And ever since that day, I really had an intense fear of needles. And it's gotten so bad for me that I actually passed out after getting needle. Like, when it went into my arm, I passed out. I remember my vision went black, I started feeling real dizzy, and I remember I lost every bit of energy, and I dropped my phone. And I don't know how long I was up, but I was up for a little bit of time. Now, I actually passed out twice from getting a needle. I passed out twice. So 90 to 95% of my experiences when I've gotten a needle, it's been fine, it's been standard. I'm not gonna say it's good. I don't think no one really likes to be injected unless they're a maniac. But most of the experience has been fine, but that one experience completely ruined it for me. And the thing is, you know, I try to tell myself, you know, oh, you know, it's going to be fine. I've done it before, it's relatively, not relatively painless, but not much pain. But I can't get that to translate to my brain. My brain is like, oh my god, a needle, I'm about to die. Now, I grew up in the hood, so anyone who's grown up in the hood knows a lot of crazy things happen in the hood. So you either see crazy things or you are a part of crazy things, willingly or sometimes unwillingly, many times unwillingly. So I've been jumped. People would try to stab me. I had a gun put to my face. What else? There's been gunshots on blocks that I've been on. No one has ever shot at me, but people shot at people while I was in certain areas. So those things are not uncommon in the hood. Those are things that happen. And all of those things, maybe except having a gun put to my face, pale in comparison to the fear that I'm experiencing when I'm about to get an injection. Like, my brain instantly tells me, oh, you're about to die. I know it's not the case. I know it's very irrational, but that's a very real thing for me. And I know, you know, there's many suggestions. You seek therapy. They tell you, look away. They could put some numbing cream. But literally none of that has ever worked for me for the past 10 years. I know it's relatively harmless, but nothing works that to help me get over that phobia. And I don't really, well, I know why, but I don't know why it's so intense for me. So I used to joke around with my brother, even though they didn't have the death penalty in New York, I would never murder someone because I don't want to get the death penalty. I don't want to get the lethal injection. You know, except that one person you want to murder, I wouldn't murder that person because I'm joking. I wouldn't murder anybody either way. But if I were a super crazy person, definitely if I lived in a state where they had the lethal injection, that would completely deter me. I'd be the most law-abiding citizen in history. I wouldn't even jaywalk. Because that's how, if you could get the lethal injection for it, that's how intense my fear of needles is. So the fear has gotten so intense that I've actually been considering putting off my surgery. I really shouldn't, because I know I've been struggling to walk for 10 years, and this is something that can help me have some mobility and be possibly pain free. But just that fear of the needle going into me, it's like I'm thinking, can I reschedule? Should I reschedule? I don't know what to do. And I'm not really looking for, if you want to give me advice, fine, but I'm not really looking for advice. I'm just I'm being real, I'm being honest. Because I know I'm not the only person that experiences things like this. Literally, 16% of the population has similar fears that I do. And it's even prevented me from getting the vaccine, an intense fear of needles. So some people look at me like, oh, he's this like relatively muscular guy, afraid of needles. Yes, I am. Very afraid. And I don't care if someone wants to make fun of me, say whatever, call me whatever. I really don't care. I'm not going to block you. You want to say it. Say whatever the hell you want. I don't care. I don't block anybody. Well, the only person I ever did block was this one person who was saying a whole bunch of nonsense to me. And I knew him in real life. We got into altercations before. And I was a clear victor. And if I didn't block this dude, I would have knocked him out. So I'm happy I did block this dude. But that's the only person that I did block. My uncle had to talk me out of not knocking this dude out for a second time. But other than that, I've never blocked anybody. So if you want to say whatever, you can say whatever. You can make fun of me. I don't care. I might laugh along with you. But, yeah, that has been a really intense fear of mine. And I'm sharing this story because I know I'm not the only person, because literally 16% of the population have similar fears. So that's all I got to say for this video. If you like content, like and subscribe to the channel. Turn on post notifications so I post videos in the future, because YouTube will not share my videos unless you do so. But I got to leave you with one more thing before the video is over, and that's the word of the day. The word of the day for today is fear. Fear is spelled F-E-A-R. The definition of fear is an unpleasant emotion caused by the belief that someone or something is dangerous, likely to cause pain or a threat. So now I will attempt to use fear in a sentence. The intense fear of needles, or trypanophobia, is the reason that 5.3 million Americans who actually want the vaccine has not gotten it as of yet, or may not get it. Hopefully I used that sentence correctly. Oh, I forgot one other thing I wanted to say about this whole thing. So, you know, COVID has killed a lot of people. It's killed over, I believe, well over 500,000 people in America alone. But it's like my brain tells me the needle is more dangerous. Like, I'm much more fearful of the needle than I am of, you know, COVID. And like I said, it's not rational, but it's real. And like I said, I named my channel Keep It 100 Dre because I'll be honest about how I feel about things. And be honest about myself too. And that's something that's honest about me. So that's something y'all know. So if you like content, like, subscribe to the channel, turn on post notifications. If you want to donate any money to help bring a better viewing experience, you can donate to my Patreon. My Patreon is www.patreon.com/keep100dre. You can donate anywhere between $3 to $10 a month to help the channel grow massively. Or you can donate to my Buy Me a Coffee account if you want to donate any more. That's www.buymeacoffee.com/keep100dre. It's going to be both linked in the description below if you want to do so. Other than that, watch my George Floyd documentary. My George Floyd documentary speaks about the system that allowed George Floyd to be murdered, how much further we came in the past year, and how much more we have to go before actual justice is served. So I would really appreciate y'all watching that, because that's my best work. At least let's get to 100 views. So that's all I gotta say for this video. I appreciate y'all watching. I'm the Tennis. Peace.
I mean, I want them to blow Noah Mojo doing the people.
Woo!
Oh!
Somebody! Oh!
He needs some milk!
Oh!
Y'all go help her, y'all!
Y'all, he gonna die! He having a seizure, I bet you, Sparkle!
No, he needs some milk! They got milk, I know!
Well, I've been stacking up. Nah, really, that ain't accurate, cause I just spent my whole damn advance in the past couple months just to compensate for times we ain't have enough. Ooh.